A quarter of adults in Britain are so obsessed with cleaning and tidying that they spend 4 years of their waking lives on household chores, with many feeling compelled to abide by strict regimes and rituals.
Every time I use a toothpaste, it needs to be cleaned. How can you use it again? It's dirty.
I use toys in my sink. I know where my partner's been in there, because every sun down there.
After I've finished hoovering, I will do my stripes just to get nice straight lines, and I will walk around the edges because I don't want to ruin the stripes on my carpet.
But for most of us, keeping our homes clean and tidy is not a priority.
I've seen it all now. This is just something else. I mean, this is like a different level.
In fact, 1 in 10 don't change their bed linen more than once a month.
I've changed my bed once a year. There's only me sleeping in it.
And 70% of people admit to moving furniture around to cover stains on their carpets so they don't have to clean them.
Oh my God.
Can a group of obsessive cleaners transform the habits of a nation?
Are you doing any cleaning today? Because I'm not doing all this myself.
Or will this prove too much?
I'm going to go sick. I really am.
I'm still keeping them. Do what you like.
For the people whose need for perfection...
What's all that, Michael Carr?
That is grot.
...has become an obsession.
And how long has that been there for?
Am I supposed to know? I didn't vomit.
I think the toilet's the most intimate instrument in the house, and I clean this toilet after every use.
52-year-old cafe owner Sandra spends 5 hours a day keeping her three-bedroomed home in North Wales looking immaculate.
For me, a Sandra home is a home that's sparkling, it's a home with lots of bling, lovely and clean, and lots of love.
Although not OCD diagnosed, Sandra has an obsession with her vacuum cleaners.
I start my day every day hoovering, just in case any dust has fallen overnight. I have 3 hoovers, one I use for downstairs, one I use for upstairs, and one I use for nooks and crannies. I don't want to cross-contaminate.
Hi, Sandy, baby, I'm home.
Sandra's partner of 5 years, Rob, has had to learn to abide by her strict cleaning routines.
When Rob comes in from work, he knows straight away that he has to remove his outdoor clothing and then get into his indoor clothes, which are pyjamas only, because we never wear anything we've worn outside, inside, not to contaminate anything. We have outdoor slippers, downstairs slippers, bedroom slippers, you know, and lots of spare pairs.
I found that it's much easier to do as Sandra wants me to do, as she tells me to do. It makes Sandra happier, which makes us both happy.
And there's one room in the house she's particularly proud of.
I think that if you've got a beautiful bed, it just needs to be dressed properly. So I use this bad boy to help me out. I like to make sure they have 9 inches to the end of the bed. I can't stand bad smells, so I walk around the house with 2 air fresheners, like my guns, so I go through about 8 bottles of air freshener a week. I think people that don't clean are really lazy. There's no excuse for not cleaning.
Sandra will be leaving her pristine home to help someone with a very different attitude to cleaning.
I'm hoping that putting myself in a dirty house will make me appreciate how clean my house is, and then I won't be so quick to jump out of bed and start cleaning and feel, in general, more relaxed.
Hi, darling. Take care.
Sandra has travelled over 300 miles to Norfolk to meet someone at the opposite end of the cleaning spectrum.
Oh, you can't be serious. Oh, a boat! Oh my God, it's... Oh.
It's easier to use the chopstick at the moment because otherwise it means doing all the washing up and it's just wrecking my head just thinking about it.
37-year-old record shop owner Carl lives on his 2-berth boat on the Norfolk Broads with his trusty dog Cooper.
So this is my boat. Lovely home it is, been for me for the last 10 years. Been slowly renovating the boat, make it more open plan. And alas, now I've just filled it all up and I can't move for anything. Here's the bedroom area. A little bit cluttered. Well, I suppose that's an understatement, really. You can't even move. Here's the bathroom, or the headroom, as it's called, in the boat. And it's been a long time since that's been cleaned. Cleaning, horrible thought. Makes me shudder inside, really. There's far more important things to be doing. It's just not enough hours in the day. I fix my sandwich-making skills. We don't need a knife, see. I think those cobwebs have got to have been there for at least 5 years. I think they're wonderful. And the spiders in my eyes are equal beings and they deserve to live on the boat just as much as I do.
But without a deep clean for over 3 years, the cobwebs and dirt are starting to take over.
The years are flying by, not far from 40 now, and I've looked around and seen some of my friends that have lived in what I would consider squalor, and really I'm realising now that perhaps my life isn't too much different, and I need to change it.
Hello.
Hello there, my dear. How you doing?
I'm okay. I'm Sandra.
My name's Carl.
I'm pleased to meet you.
And you? Something different for you?
I'm not great on board, but I'm sure you'll be there to help me, yeah?
No worries.
Okay.
Go for it.
Thank you very much. Oh, my God. Oh, flipping heck. It is horrendous. The sink is filthy. The floor is filthy. There's empty beer bottles here. There's cobwebs everywhere. I'm even frightened to turn around in case there's something lurking behind me. I'm just scared. This is a nightmare. And I've only just got 2 steps into the door.
In here we've got the headroom. That's what we call the bathroom.
Oh, that's a nasty looking toilet, isn't it? It's bloody filthy. Oh. Is that pubic hair? Please say it's not.
No, that'd be my beard.
Please. But... All right. I think I'm a bit more comfortable with facial hair than pubic hair. What's that broken thing in the corner?
Oh, that'd be the scented candle.
All right, OK. It's not giving off much of a smell, love. Well, this is a lovely home for all the little buggy-wuggies, isn't it?
But they've got just as much entitlement to be here as I have.
Really?
Yes, we're all equal on this planet.
You won't find any in my house, so we're going to make this
a bit, like us.
A bit like a Sandra home, OK?
No.
Yes, we are. While I was inside with Carl, I felt quite light-hearted because I wanted to encourage him to feel that we can do this together. But the way he is living, it just makes me appreciate what I've got. I just really want to help him a lot.
Before they embark on 4 days of solid cleaning, Sandra is keen to give Carl an idea of the standards she keeps at her home.
Look at that bed. I use a tape measure to make sure that the cushions are evenly placed. Okay?
Don't you think that's going a little bit far?
Maybe it is.
Perfectly placed cushion is when you get up and you leave it, see it moulded into your hair, because that's moulded perfectly to your backside, right? And that's a perfect cushion to me.
You stopped me from crying there when you made me laugh.
Good.
I can tell we're going to be a great team, OK?
Great job.
And this is my immaculate kitchen. I own a cafe, and when I see the way your dishes are, it really scares the hell out of me.
I'm just curious where you find the time to do all the cleaning and then run a cafe.
Well, I get up extra early. My husband generally goes on ahead, because he knows I'm going to be late.
You're late for work because you're cleaning?
Yes. I own 3 Hoovers.
3? Okay?
Some for downstairs, some for upstairs. I don't like to cross-contaminate. We have slippers for upstairs and slippers for downstairs,
good
okay?
Heavens.
Equally, we don't wear outdoor clothing indoors. We come in and we put our pyjamas on.
Well, I can say it's good heavens. Well, 3 Hoovers that have been made for one household, it's just preposterous. It's bad for the environment. Dirt is dirt. Just let go up the Hoover.
Carl thinks that Sandra's world is a bit extreme. Sometimes Sandra thinks that Sandra's world is a bit extreme. But we're going to crack this and that man is going to be so happy.
...60% of Brits have shut doors to certain rooms in their homes so guests can't see the mess. But that's not the case for mother of two, Maxine.
The glasses are all paired up, so they're either in twos or in fours. When there's even numbers, it's more perfect, it's equal.
The 44-year-old former nurse spends 20 hours a week keeping her 3-bedroom home in Sheffield perfectly ordered.
This is my tin cupboard. Everything's facing, and I also pair things up, so my pineapple tins, I put them both together. One of the problems I have is if one of the children doesn't want beans and one wants ravioli, that can... I sometimes look and I say, oh, boys, can't you both have beans? Because you know what'll happen to the cupboard.
Although not OCD diagnosed, Maxine has developed a cleaning routine to keep her home pristine.
Dust is a big problem. I hoover the whole house every day. I hoover the TV, the radiators, do the cushions. I hoover the blinds, I do hoover the toaster, and maybe hoover kids. I really love chrome. I like it to look like when you first get something. So I use baby oil. Put a tiny bit onto a fry cloth and just wipe it around. It just makes it look like it's just come straight out of the shop. Looks fantastic.
Maxine's been with her partner Andrew for over 3 years, although they don't live together.
I can see it hanging off at end.
Do you want to come up and do it?
No.
I'm a clean and tidy person anyway. But she takes it to a whole new level. Maxine on a Friday night, she's not that bothered about going out. I think she's sooner staying and clean.
In an attempt to change her ways, Maxine is leaving her orderly home to help someone with a very messy problem.
I think I've got a routine and a need for order. If somebody could help me relax that so I don't feel the need, the desire, the anxiousness that comes with it when it's not done, that'd be great.
I've done you a list.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm sorry, but please, just keep it tidy, all right?
Keep it tidy,
thank you.
Right.
See you in a few days.
See you in a few days.
Bye, love. Bye.
Bye.
Maxine has travelled over 100 miles, also to Norfolk, to help someone with a very different approach to housekeeping.
Just a little bit unkept. It's fine. I love clothes. I just don't look after them very well.
70-year-old glamorous granny Diane's lived in a two-bedroom house in Norwich for 38 years.
Appearance and fashion and clothes in general are very important, I think, because this is how I present myself to the world.
And since the home hasn't had a deep clean in over 3 years, it has become her dirty secret.
Well, three of my friends know what sort of a state the place is in, but no one visits here because I don't want anybody to see what it's like, quite honestly. I've had a problem with the flies. That's a particularly nasty specimen. I'm very, very ashamed of the kitchen. I mean, that is the worst room of all. I've had to start going over the road to a cafe to get my breakfast now.
Best friend Barbara has known retired librarian Diane since the 60s, but even she hasn't been allowed past the front door in over 2 years.
Yeah. I just can't believe you let it go like this again. I really can't.
Yeah. You would not dream at the sort of chaos that she lives in.
Look!
Yes, I was wondering if I could bring my cups round to yours and put them in your dishwasher.
Not unless you disinfect them first.
Her energy when she's confronted with any sort of art, cultural thing, opera, historic house, is phenomenal. Show a vacuum cleaner, it's total inertia.
Yes, it's a bit dangerous walking through here because you don't know what you're standing on. Well, my outward appearance doesn't really reflect what my house is like at all. I've kept it a secret. Yes. It would be nice to be able to invite people round once it's all tidy and respectable again. Hello, I'm Diane.
Hi,
come
well.
In.
Nice
how
to meet
do you
I'm
do?
I'm Maxine.
Come on through.
Thank you.
Now, this is the sitting room, really. It's where I spend most of my time.
Okay. It's just a lot of stuff, Diane.
Yes, there is. It's all just got beyond me, really. I don't know what to start with it.
These sort of empty bottles and...
Yes.
It's kind of a bit of a mix, really.
Yes, it needs to go in the recycling.
But it looks like there's some things down here that are important. Like, you know, you've got your books and you don't want to get spoilt and, you know.
Yes. Very cluttered again.
It is.
Yes.
It is. I don't want to sound rude, but I've noticed the sink.
Yeah.
That's quite bad.
Yes, it is.
So, what is your cleaning routine? Do you have a cleaning routine?
No, I don't have a cleaning routine at all, no, I'm afraid. It's just boring, isn't it, you know? It always seems a rather futile exercise, because you have to do
so
it all
brushing
again.
Brushing your teeth, though, Diane. Brushing your teeth and washing your face is futile, if you think about it like that, you know?
Yes, yeah. Come through here.
You've got some beautiful things. Are these scarves or fabrics? Or?
Oh, yes, I like my scarves, yeah.
It's getting spoiled.
Yes,
do you not think, Diane, I'm stunned at the things that you've got, the cases, the trunk, the beautiful furniture. They tell like a story. This is who you are. This is your identity. And yet it's hidden beneath rubbish that can just be cleared out and taken to the bin. When I first met Diane, the first impression when she came to the door, I did. I scanned her up and down and just thought, she looks fantastic. So well presented, beautiful clothes. And then we walk into the first room, I'm like, this person doesn't fit with this.
On the Norfolk Broads, it's the first day of the clean. Cafe owner Sandra has just 4 days to tackle Carl's 38-foot boat. And with her concerns for contamination, she's taking full precautions.
Oh, I think I have to have a cover-up here because it's so messy in there. Oh my gosh, I feel so itchy.
Sandra plans to clean the entire boat, starting with the kitchen.
Morning.
Come on in.
But before she can get down to it, they need to clear the area of 8 years' worth of clutter.
You got gloves on, you know?
Right, look. Even the gloves are scared.
Some of these bits of paperwork might be important receipts for my bookkeeping, believe it or not. That's still relevant in the last tax year, so...
All right, OK. Oh, my God. Is it just all mouldy? I don't know how long it's been there. I feel, like, vomiting. And just... And there's a smell.
Oh, what's wrong with it?
Oh, my God. Get it out.
That's a bit right.
Oh, my God. I'm loving all your herbs.
And no, you're not. You're throwing them away.
I'm loving them, but they're just really old.
You haven't even looked at one day, so you're not giving any of the thought.
Carl, yeah. The amount of dust and dirt that's on there, they're not months out of date, they are years out of date. I can tell.
You've done the rest of it. You might as well check the last 3-4 containers away now. That's it, done.
Done.
No more herbs.
With the back of the boat cleared, Sandra can finally get down to some heavy scrubbing.
What made you think of living on a boat then, Carl?
As a child, although I had the pleasure of living with my mum in a stable house, I spent all of my free time with my dad in the back of his truck, going to Glastonbury festivals, living free. And I suppose the thought of perhaps being a bit like my dad.
Free spirit.
Not tied down and not being a good consumer like they all want us to be, so.
Yes, okay. He's a little bit different to me. He lives a different alternative lifestyle. He's a bit hippie-ish. That's great. But it doesn't mean that he needs to live the way he has been living. And even though he lives on a boat, he can still keep it nice and clean and tidy. And he knows there's no excuse.
When did you first realise that you were starting to enjoy the cleaning opposed to just getting the cleaning done?
When I was 18 and I had my first home, and I would always clean, but I would pay particular attention when my friends were coming round because they would say, oh gosh, Sam, this looks lovely. And to be honest, I fed off it. It made me feel good. It made me feel proud.
It's clear to me that you're a cleaning addict.
Yes. Right?
You're addicted
yes.
to it and it's gone too far. It's just got a habit, is what I'd class as a bad habit. I think Sandra being on the boats will be a start to opening her mind up. Then when she goes back and looks and she goes, oh, that's nice and clean still. And maybe she'll just leave it for one morning and go and do something different.
Obsessive compulsive disorder affects hundreds of thousands of people across the UK. Sufferers have their lives dominated by obsessive thoughts and compulsive acts.
On the most extreme cases, I've probably cleaned my table up to 15 times in one day.
Mum of three, Hayley, was diagnosed with OCD 7 years ago. She has a fear of dirt and germs that can make her scrub the house for up to 19 hours a day.
I feel like if I don't carry out certain rituals and clean things a certain way, that something bad will happen. Facing my fears is really important because I think it reiterates the fact that the OCD is just a fault and nothing bad is going to happen if I come into contact with things that are dirty.
But Hayley wants to confront her obsessive thoughts.
That's so gross!
Each week she'll invite two equally obsessive cleaners to join her in using their extreme methods to tackle some of Britain's dirtiest places.
Oh my...
Together they will face their fear of germs head on.
Sorry, I think I'm going to be sick.
This week, they'll be tackling showers. After demonstrating how they clean their own, they'll put their methods to work on these filthy showers at a busy amateur football club.
I will use neat bleach over everything, and then once I've done that, I will steam just to make sure that there's no bacteria left lurking around. I feel like now I've steamed it, any germs that were left over are now burning in hell. That makes me happy.
Hayley will be joined by personal trainer, Vinny.
It's very important for me to have my shower and my taps shining.
Although not OCD diagnosed, Vinny cleans his shower 365 days a year.
My shower head comes off day and night, left in a bowl, soaked in bleach. I love shining, you can see my face in it.
Cleaner number three is medical scientist Chris. Also not OCD diagnosed, he can scrub his shower for up to 4 hours a week.
The first step what I do, I pour the full bottle of the bleach around the cabinet. The bacteria, they are little boogers because they always find the little spots. Toothbrushes are absolutely perfect tool to get into corners, as simple as that.
The cleaners are swabbing their own showers to establish how sterile they are. Any score under 500 means the surface is clean enough to eat off.
I got a 3, such a good score.
Well done, very proud of you.
Oh, it's 8. It's still very, very low. I'm very happy with that.
So they've all got their own showers extremely clean. Next, they want to apply their methods to these communal showers at a busy football club. How will the cleaners cope?
Oh, he's going to drip on me!
And will they be able to bring them up to their standards?
Oh, you're going to put that there deliberately.
I swear I didn't.
Yeah, yeah.
I haven't.
It's the first day of the clean in Norwich.
Good morning, Maxine.
Hi, Marianne, how are you?
I'm okay, thank you.
Thank you.
and order-obsessed Maxine has 4 days to clean and clear 70-year-old Diane's bedroom, kitchen and lounge.
Shall we start from the floor and work our way upwards and clear the floor first? I think that's how to date, Duck.
Yes, it is.
December 2014, so, you know. I don't know what that was, but it's wet. And it stinks.
That's
so rubbish. Stuff growing on that.
Yeah, rubbish.
Who's done these?
Me.
Goodness. Wow, these are absolutely stunning. Just men, then.
There are some women, I think.
Not bothered about women, to be honest, but what a talented lady you are. Wow. I notice you've got books from far and wide places.
Well, I buy the guidebook whenever I go anywhere. I've travelled a great deal in the Eastern Mediterranean, really, and North Africa as well. Mm. Yeah, I think Turkey was a great country, and I had great times in Syria. And Libya was brilliant.
Was it?
Yeah.
I'm really fond of her. I think she's an incredibly intelligent woman with a very colourful life. So much to learn from this woman. She's wonderful.
With the lounge cleared, they move on to the bedroom, and 70-year-old Diane, who can't stand for long periods of time, makes a start on the mountain of clothes.
OK.
This definitely doesn't fit anymore and never will fit again.
Fine.
So that can go.
It can go. Do you mind me asking how long you've been on your own?
Oh, over 20 years.
Really?
Yes, my husband died in 1992, so that just left me...
Do you think perhaps, you know,
I had to keep the kitchen clean and tidy because I was preparing meals and things like that. And, of course, really, the more I was on my own, it seems a waste of time.
It's OK to keep things nice just for you.
I've always been happier doing things for other people. I go and cat sit for my friend Barbara, sometimes for up to 5 weeks, and she says when she comes back you wouldn't know anybody had been there.
She wants to do... lots for other people, which is wonderful. It's just such a shame. She doesn't seem to allow herself to do the same for herself. Yeah.
Back on the Norfolk Broads, it's halfway through the clean for cafe owner Sandra and record collector Carl, and they've already removed 12 boxes of junk from the boat.
Carl's been really good. He's got rid of loads of stuff, much more than I thought, and it's been really easy to get along with because he's been so helpful in getting rid of all the rubbish.
But there are some things which won't be thrown away.
That's my mother's crystal ball. She was a witch.
Was she?
Yeah.
Oh, right, okay.
Carl lost his mother 8 years ago.
There's some other things in the corner of the room. There's some kind of a leg, but I am late to ask you, Carl, because I obviously haven't seen you without trousers on, so I wasn't sure if it might be a spare one.
That was my mother's leg.
Really?
Yes. As a child, I was a carer from the age of 4 or 5, because my mum was disabled. So I spent a long time cleaning.
And how old were you at this point?
5. I can remember being told to go and wash up, so I'd go and wash up, and it wouldn't be good enough, so she put it all back on the side and I'd have to do it again.
Ah, right, I see. Would you say in your adult life that's put you off cleaning?
Potentially, yeah.
Maybe stupidly, I thought people who lived, no disrespect, in the dirt that you lived in, were lazy people. And now I see it from a different angle. You know, there's a lot more to you than I could ever imagine.
Yes.
Yeah. I just feel so sad for him that he's had a lot of things in his life that I had no idea. And I'm looking at me, and at this moment in time, I don't like me. I need to look at Sandra and realise that sometimes she makes her mind up about things and it's not the way.
Germs live everywhere, and most people come into contact with millions of them every single day. For those that are healthy, it isn't an issue. But for some sufferers of OCD, it can be a problem.
I don't think I ever feel happy with my home. It never feels completely germ-free.
Hayley has invited 2 obsessive cleaners to help her tackle some filthy showers at a busy football club.
I really do feel by us being here and tackling this, we are really going to be pushing our boundaries. Oh, he's going to dribble me!
Hayley hopes by bringing them here, they will face their fear of germs in public places.
Water!
The worst part about my showers is everything. The plasters, has that been on a blister that's burst, and there's all that juice from the blister. Oh, it's going to make me go in a minute.
First, the cleaners swab the showers to see how much dirt they have to eliminate. A reading of over 1,000 could increase the risk of harmful bacteria being present.
Oh,
Oh my god.
These grotty showers have a reading of up to 5,322.
I think toilet water would be cleaner.
Dressed especially for the occasion, they've been allocated one shower each and will use their own cleaning techniques to see if they can get a lower score.
The worst bit for me is the bodily bits, the dead skin, the man hairs. That is a big no-no for me.
Oh!
Oh, you're having a laugh, Ayla. You're going to put that there deliberately,
aren't you? I swear I didn't.
Yeah.
I haven't.
With a third of household showers harbouring potentially dangerous bacteria, these cleaners really have their work cut out.
I won't go.
Ooh.
I was like a little monster. Wouldn't want to leave the wall.
I reckon we're going to need some sort of, like, industrial sander to get the lime scale off of these shower heads.
I love the mess.
2 hours of scrubbing and 4 bottles of bleach later, the showers are as clean as a whistle. Before, these changing rooms were teeming with bacteria. Quick swab will reveal how clean they are now. A reading of 500 or under is considered clean enough to eat off.
Oh my god.
Am I going to do the funky chicken?
What do you reckon yours is going to be?
Not zero. Zero.
Look. It's so high.
141 is well below 500, so I do think it is a good score. Five.
Brilliant.
That's not bad, is it, at all? I think what we've done today is amazing because we have literally surrounded ourselves for a full day with the most vile, filthiest, grimy bacteria, germs and dirt, which I think was really brave of us.
Especially with me and my bodily hair.
Yeah, you don't like a pubic hair, do you, Vinny?
I feel like we really, really achieved something. You don't need to be always scared of, you know, horrific dirt.
My shower at home will never be dirty, but I don't think after today I'll need to clean it as much.
Back in Norwich, part-time lecturer Maxine is halfway through the 4-day clean of Diane's house. The lounge and bedroom have been cleared, and now Maxine needs to tackle the bug-infested kitchen, which is overrun with mouldy cups and plates.
That's a banana skin. That's a banana.
I think I saw a banana lurking around here somewhere.
Yes. Nope, doesn't want to go.
Oh.
There we go. That's like bigger mortis, that.
Yeah.
How long's this water been in this sink? Are we talking months or years?
15 months.
Yeah. Okay. I think we'll have to do that one on its own, because I'm not sure what's growing in that.
That's all fruit flies, isn't there?
Fruit flies.
Mm. Okay. I don't think it smells very nasty.
It's this, Diane.
Oh.
I know. Diane, do you want to know how I get my sink so shiny?
Oh, yes, I'd love to know how you do that.
Baby oil.
Well, I've never seen anything like that. I have to say, I've travelled very widely and I've worked in public service and I've not seen that. So, how much of each day would you say you spend on cleaning and tidying?
It can be up to 4 hours a day.
Really?
And it's more at the weekends, you see.
So, your obsession with cleaning, did you start when you were very young?
From being a small child, I'd always like things in order. You know, bedroom was always in order. I used to lay in bed at night and try and get myself straight and symmetrical. I used to practice at holding my breath so that my body didn't move at all. And I used to think that bogeyman used to come and get me, you see, for not being perfect. But yeah, I can remember being quite aware at a young age, thinking, I think I'm a bit straight. I think I'm a bit odd.
Yeah, did it to do with superstition?
I've not thought of that.
For some people, don't think something will go well if they don't put their clothes on in the right order.
I have a routine. I struggle a little bit if that routine gets broken. I'm dreadful. I can be short-tempered at work. And do you know, the minute I'm able to leave work to come home, the minute I open the door, I think, oh, brilliant, I'm home. And then I can, you know, get my little jobs done. I've used cleaning for years as a comfort blanket to kind of hide behind. There's lots of other stuff that I'd like to do, and I don't do it. If Diane were to write about what she'd done, she could probably fill those bookshelves with those memories. I'm not sure that my life would be able to fill a shelf. I don't want the gravestone. She kept a nice house. She were a dead good cleaner. I don't want that gravestone. Thank you.
It's the penultimate day on the Norfolk Broads, and with the boat largely cleaned, Sandra has finally plucked up the courage to tackle the smallest but most contaminated room on the boat.
I think that probably the room that's scaring me the most is the bathroom.
Oh, Carl, this is disgusting.
Yeah.
The boat is totally pushing me out of my comfort zone because I have never cleaned anything so dirty in my life.
There's some kind of tray here.
Yes, there is a tray there.
Can you tell me what the purpose of the tray is?
You see the toilet?
Yeah.
On the valve. It's got a bit of a leak. So when you pump it to flush it,
yeah,
a little bit of the pish comes out too.
Oh, my God.
So the tray's under there to catch it.
Have we got a new tray or a clean tray?
Yeah, we can clean that one.
I tell you what, I'll do a deal with you, okay? Oh. I'll clean the rest of the bathroom if you pull the tray out and sort it out while I turn around so I can't see you.
It's only a bit of pish.
I feel quite sweaty when you feel like I want to throw up. The smell is just vile.
I cannot deny that I have found some humour in this situation. It's only a bit of pish. I shouldn't laugh. But I am.
The thing is, I think Carl finds this part funny, but I've only just met Carl, and I'm cleaning one of the most personal rooms in his boat. And I don't think he realises how hard this is for me, you know? Oh my God, the smell of piss is unbelievable. Well, Carl, I think this girl's all scrubbed out today.
You met your match today, but you conquered and you overcome.
I did.
Well done.
This is the first day I have not enjoyed cleaning. I realise now that I don't actually clean my house. I just wipe clean surfaces all the time. I know that I'm going to go home and I am definitely going to do more relaxing. It's like today has been the flick of the switch.
It's the final day of the clean in Norwich, and Maxine and Diane are putting some finishing touches to the house clean.
The clean has gone much better than I ever imagined. It's been fantastic.
We've grown quite close in a very short space of time, and I value her very much, and I hope to see her again.
My friend Barbara's coming, and she will be absolutely amazed when she sees what it's like. I'm looking forward to seeing her face.
I'm really hoping that it will reflect Diane and her sense of colour and style, and will be somewhere she wants to invite people back to. And it's just exciting. New start.
Barbara! Oh, lovely to see you.
4 days ago, Diane's sitting room contained a mountain of abandoned papers and junk, with nowhere to relax. Now, with her books neatly shelved, it's a homely space to sit and read.
Great. Absolutely great. What did you do with all the...
It's gone. Poof. Gone.
Binned. Brilliant. You've done well.
Diane's done very well.
But it's been a voyage of discovery. We've found all these pairs of specs.
I think you've got a good collection.
I've got about 7 pairs now.
So you just nip out and get another pair when you couldn't find them?
Yeah.
I think it's amazing that you've actually got rid of all those papers.
It's been quite an experience getting rid of all this stuff, but I was just overwhelmed by it all.
Couldn't be better.
Before, the bedroom was a cluttered mess, with discarded clothes covering the floor. Now it's been restored to a neat and tranquil space.
This is the bedroom, Barbara.
Oh, that is superb. That looks beautifully fresh. It really does.
Yes.
When I first arrived, it were like mountaineering.
Well, it was just a mountain of clothes.
Oh, there was a lot of clothes. We've got floor space, of which there was none before.
Yeah. They just feel so fresh and clean.
The finish on this room is a better reflection of Diane. Yeah. You know, it's glam. It's got colour.
No, I really think you've done so well.
Previously, Diane's kitchen was a grotty mess. The dirty sink contained stagnant water that hadn't been changed in 15 months. Now it's fresh and clean, with room to prepare food and a sparkling sink.
It's wonderful. It's superb. I love it.
Yes.
I just don't remember seeing this much kitchen surface ever before.
There was no kitchen surface. There wasn't any at all.
Well, it looks like it did when it was brand new, 15 years ago. Now,
really?
I think, yes. Yeah. I just think it's wonderful, I really do, and I'm so grateful for what you've done for me.
Well, I'll be checking up on you.
I hope Maxine and I will keep in touch, because Maxine was a lovely person. I was delighted to meet her.
Well, thank you so much for everything. Oh, yeah.
I'm so happy now that the house is respectable at last, and I shall be able to invite people in, and yes, I feel liberated.
Okay, well, take care.
Okay, keep it clean.
It's been a pleasure.
Bye-bye.
I'll always enjoy cleaning, but I'm certainly going to go away. I'm going to be more mindful about how much time I spend doing it and think, put the Hoover down and go and do something. But I'm going to make sure it's not on my tombstone that I kept a clean house.
How would you feel if I gave your mother's leg a bit of a rub down?
You can rub my mother's leg if you like.
It's the final day of the clean on the Norfolk Broads.
I'll tie the lace into a nice bow. And girls like bows. There we go, my dear. Pride of place.
And there's just time for Sandra to get the soft furnishings precisely in place.
What are you doing there?
Just checking the distance of your cushions, Carl.
That's over the top. You don't need to be doing that.
Everything in Sandy's world is perfect. Okay?
And good friend Becky can't wait to see the fruits of their labour.
Probably the worst thing about Carl's boat before was just the lack of space. It felt so cramped. When I used to go around to Carl's boat, I wouldn't have wanted to eat there or touch things. But I'm hoping that all will have changed now, will have been total transformation.
I'm
Becky, lovely to meet you.
Before, the kitchen was grim and greasy and teeming with bacteria. Now it's bright and airy and hygienically clean.
Oh, come aboard.
Oh my goodness! I'm pretty speechless, if I'm honest. Yeah. I can't believe there's so much space. Really great first impression.
There's clean mugs. Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Here.
Right, I'll have
so
a cup of tea
you
later.
Can have a cup of tea. Yeah.
Can't wait.
5 days ago, the bathroom was a stinking hole and home to a disgusting tray of wee. Now it's sparkling and smelling fresh as a daisy.
It looks so clean. You've even got flowers in your bathroom. Yeah. How beautiful. It's like something in a B&B.
So much better, doesn't it?
It does. It looks so spacious. It's a different bathroom, you know.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about having such a beautifully clean bathroom now?
It's a pleasure to use the bathroom as opposed to hold my breath and open the window.
Finally, Carl's sitting room was an unsavoury dumping ground, littered with dirty cups and used ashtrays. Now it's clean and clear with everything shipshape.
This looks amazing. It looks like double the space.
Yeah, a nice clear wheelhouse.
And you've got space to sit down without sitting on anything and space to put your drinks down without having to worry about knocking things over.
I'm really happy for Carl.
Absolutely.
You know, that he's got a lovely, comfortable environment.
Yeah, of course. You've both done an incredible job. It looks like a totally transformed space, you know, it's like a different boat. Oh, I thought the boat looked absolutely incredible. It was such a transformation. I'm so happy for Carl.
This will be the last time you're doing this,
eh? Ah, yeah.
Before I go, okay, I just got a little gift for you. You know how much I love my slippers.
Well,
these are for you.
Very dashing, very pink.
Wear them wisely.
Well, thank you for your help.
It's been my pleasure.
What I learned from this whole experience is don't let it happen again. All right, don't let it build up. Instead of putting it down, put it in a bin.
Apart from I've had the most memorable time of my life, the coldest time, the dirtiest time, God, man, I've learned some stuff this week. I think that on a Sunday, maybe I am going to kick off my slippers, so to speak, and put my feet up on the sofa and not worry about, you know, wiping this and spraying that. Just enjoy what I've got because I'm such a lucky girl.
Click, click, smile. It's cutthroat, and they're only just little. Showbiz comes early at the Tiny Tots Talent Agency next Tuesday at 8. But coming up, you do see a dad change in the delivery room, and for three fellas, they're experiencing just that in One Born on 4 Next.